Hey, what's going on, guys? The Horror Man back on Slashback Saturday. This week's Slashback Challenge theme was unique setting slashers. I challenged everyone to watch and review a slasher film with a unique setting. I mentioned that you could watch a slasher film with a typical camp or high school setting, but there had to be something unique about the camp or high school. Or you obviously could have watched a slasher film with a totally unique setting. And that's what I did, because the slasher film I watched is set at a zoo. In fact, it even says so in the title. I watched the 1933 slasher film, Murders in the Zoo. You heard me correctly, 1933. I'd show you the back of this box, but hey, there's nothing on it, because this here is a screener. Murders in the Zoo is definitely a slasher film, despite the fact that it was released in 1933. It strongly supports the point I was trying to make in my slasher retrospective video I uploaded earlier this week. It's about a millionaire and zoologist named Eric Gorman, who is very possessive of his wife Evelyn. With that being said, it does make sense for him to be jealous because she is unfaithful. The movie begins in the Orient, where Eric stands over his first victim in the jungle. The man is held down as Eric sews his mouth shut, telling him he will never lie to a friend again and never kiss another man's wife again. Of course, we can assume that this man had carried on an affair with Eric's wife Evelyn. Soon after, Evelyn is back at it and having an affair with another man. This time, she plans to leave Eric and take off to Paris with her new boyfriend. But first, they return home to America, where Eric delivers the animals he captured on his safari to the municipal zoo. It's at the zoo where almost the rest of the film takes place. It seems that the municipal zoo is dangerously low on funds, so they decide to hold a fundraiser. A dinner is held amongst the animals, and having learned of his wife's new affair, Eric invites the new beau to the banquet. In what seems to be a freak accident, he is bitten by a venomous snake. Obviously, though, all is not as it seems. Evelyn always knew her husband was a bit off, but she soon learns that he is in fact a madman. She finds the murder weapon in Eric's desk drawer, but I won't spoil what it is. Now, having discovered that her husband has killed not one, but two men with whom she was having an affair, Evelyn fears for her own life. And as more and more people at the zoo learn the deadly truth about Eric Gorman, the body count rises. Murders in the Zoo plays out just like a Tales from the Crypt episode. That's what it reminded me of so much. It seriously seems as if it was written like an old EC comic. Eric Gorman is a dark, cold psychopath. The zoo setting is awesome, and obviously unique. The kills are also unique, including the sewn mouth left to die death, the venomous snake bite death, and one of the victims is even chloroformed and tossed over a bridge into an alligator-infested lake. There is a final girl and a final confrontation and chase. There's even a nice little twist and surprise ending. But man, oh man, the climax of this film is incredible. There's some foreshadowing earlier in the movie that leads to a great finale. Let's just say they truly take advantage of the zoo setting. And the ending, again, like something straight out of a Tales from the Crypt episode. I really love the shots of the families and children at the zoo earlier in the film, and all the shots of the animals. I mean, what other slasher film, or even horror film for that matter, takes place at a zoo? It's truly unique, which is why Murders in the Zoo was the perfect choice for unique setting slashers. And now it's time for the new Slashback Challenge theme. Creepy Clown Slashers. I challenge everyone to watch and review a slasher film featuring a creepy clown. Now, keep in mind that the theme is not killer clown slashers, it's creepy clown slashers. The clown does not have to be the killer. Of course, that doesn't mean the killer can't be a clown. The film just has to be a slasher, and it has to feature a creepy clown. It can be one clown, or it can be multiple clowns. Killer or not, get watching and get reviewing Creepy Clown Slashers. As always, be sure to upload your video on Slashback Saturday. I will also be back on Saturday with a new review and reveal of a new theme in the Horror Man's Slashback Challenge. Thanks for watching, guys. Be kind, subscribe. Oh, give me-